Helen Keller once said, "The most beautiful things in life cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt with the heart." I'm a single mama, doing my best to get by on what I call heart work, the kind of work that feeds your soul and helps you find the silver lining in life's struggles. I live here in the East Bay with my daughters, Espy and Delilah. For my day job, I work at a gender equity center on a college campus, which means March, which is also known as Women's History Month or a time to celebrate the progress of women, is the busiest and the most ironic time.
The only problem is that it printed backwards.
On the weekends, I produce a newscast at KPFA, and this month it'll be a special all-women's newscast. It's a gig that comes with passion, but not pay. If that's not enough, when my daughter started kindergarten a couple years ago, I decided that I should go back to school. Not in pursuit of a high-paying job, but to make good on a deferred dream of being a writer. I spend a good share of my time chasing my kids, transporting them, and negotiating with them. When I'm not working, I usually have a neighborhood kid or two or sometimes five with us. Sometimes when I'm on deadline, the kids get creative and transform the bathroom to a dentist office.
Okay.
And sometimes they play nicely together,
Alexa,
for a little while.
Play Kids Bop.
And we're good. Until fight breaks up. In our neighborhood, as the rent goes up, lots of people come and go. We live in a corner lot triplex that might or might not be up to code, but it's for the bargain price of $1,900 a month. When I was younger, I couldn't wait to get away from my home in the Midwest. I flew by the seat of my pants around the world on a shoestring budget, dancing, interviewing, connecting with people from all walks of life. In this chapter, the one where I'm a single mom of two kids living in the East Bay, I yearn to be closer to the home I fled. Now I read the stories I wrote about the world I once experienced with my children as I chip away on a revised version of my childhood dream.
If someone doesn't have lunch, you can share with them. Otherwise, they'll get hungry and they might need to wait a long time.
My mom, sister, nieces, and pretty much all of my relatives live some 2,000 miles away.
When skies are gray, you'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine.
And when you're a single mama that far away from family, you have no choice but to piece together another one and bask in the possibilities of life, the universe, and chance encounters with strangers to remind you that you're not alone. This true story takes place in the spring of 2019. Before I tell it to you, I want to point out this man in a tie-dyed shirt. His name is Flip, and we'll see him again later. Okay, girls. I got stories. Let's go read a story. I'm pulling an all-nighter, writing a speech about women's rights and how far women have come as I'm getting ready to host the all-women's newscast the very next day, when I get a text from my landlord telling me that, once again, my rent check bounced. I already know that my electricity bill is overdue, and so is my tuition bill, and there's absolutely nothing I can do about it until my next paycheck, which won't be quite enough to cover it all. So I just shrug and go back to work. You see, when you're a single mama trying to make ends meet in the East Bay, you get used to a certain amount of struggle and a little bit of chaos. It's Saturday today, but not a day for sleeping in. At least, not if we want to fit in enough time to get to the park and do some fun stuff before I go to the radio station to do the International Women's Day newscast.
Mommy, I'm tired.
Mommy, do you have to go to work today?
Yeah, at the radio station, but guess what? You get to come and watch.
But you promised we could go to the farmer's market.
I know. Hurry up, and we can go now, before I bring you to Fenton's house.
Wait, but I thought you were bringing us to the news with you.
Yes, but David is gonna pick you up from Fenton's house and bring you there.
Wait, what?
It's a little bit hard for us to find our rhythm and keep our rhythm during Women's History Month, March, because it's necessarily the busiest month of the year.
Mom!
Yes, baby?
I'm brushing my hair.
Oh, good. Do you need any help?
No, I got it.
It's not easy, and it's almost never smooth or graceful. But we figured out how to get creative and resourceful.
Can we buy some cashews or almonds?
Those are too expensive, but we can get some peanuts.
Okay.
I give the girls a $20 budget for the farmer's market.
One small bag of peanuts, please.
You're welcome.
Mommy, look.
Oh, you want to try some?
Yeah.
Okay, we still have $16 left for the day. Let's go try some. Come on.
And even though we're short on both time and money, we find a way to enjoy the sweetness of life in bite-sized pieces.
Yeah. Which one did you think? Thank you.
$5 three packs, 3 for $5. Strawberry deals only $5. Yeah? I'll make it a little extra heavy for you, okay? $5, okay? Make a little handle for your bag. There you go.
Thank you.
You have a beautiful rest of your day.
Sometimes in the midst of the hustle and the struggle and the rush in between places, we slow down just long enough to enjoy the beautiful moment that we're in. Until we rush off to the next place, which means I'll drive them back to Lafayette so they can stay with my friend Fatin and her children until the next neighbor will pick them up and bring them to meet me at the radio station. I walk them upstairs and go through a dramatic transition with both of my girls, even though it'll only be 3 hours before we see each other again. I take 3 seconds to recenter myself and get ready for the sprint to get the news on the air on time. All this hustle for an unpaid job as an anchor of the KPFA Weekend Evening News. But what's the point of doing unpaid heart work to celebrate the progress of women if I can't include my daughters?
Hello?
So,
oh, you're at the front door.
An hour before I go live, David, another neighbor, arrives with both of my daughters and one of his. By now, I'm wishing that I could manufacture time as I'm on the countdown to showtime. And of course, Delilah falls and hits her head right when it's time for the news to start. Good evening, it's March 9th, 2019. I'm Sharon Sabota, and this is a special International Women's Day edition of the Weekend Evening News. Feminist writer and actress. As I read the stories that I curated to amplify the voices of women from around the world about the progress women have made, and thought about my own reality and how much hustle I went through so that my kids could share this little moment in time with me. There was an extra sort of irony to the words of Gloria Steinem, my interviewee that day.
That if women were paid equally, it's a massive redistribution of wealth. Or that if we started to really count all productive labor, including child rearing and caregiving, that's a third of the work in the country.
And that's it for this evening's news. Thanks to you, our listeners, for tuning in. And thank you to my daughters, Espy and Delilah, and the small village of neighbors who's made it possible for them to be here with me today. I'm Sharon Sabota. Good evening and happy International Women's Day weekend. After the newscast, the girls take turns interviewing each other. My neighbor's daughter asks Espy which women she looks up to, and she names two.
There's a singer named Selena that I liked. I like singers because it's something I want to be
when I grow up, and she's Latina like me. Also my mom, because she works really hard at the radio and when she writes books and makes movies.
And somehow that made the entire struggle worth it.
By Sunday, we're exhausted, but there's far too much to get done to sleep in.
I rock sweatpants and brown bare feet. No makeup, but I feel sexy. Like my skin out and my hair nappy. Hope you got a sweet tooth, cause I flow so sweet. Ooh, baby, baby, come see about me. It's been a long time coming.
I decide to start my day with a delicious cup of coffee and enjoy every sip of it until my kids wake up.
Mom, you said I could finish go this morning, and now I'm awake.
Which gives me exactly 3 seconds before Esty wakes up to remind me that I promised that she could watch Go in the morning and that we'd get to the park before the rain starts. I put on a show for Esty and begin the gigantic task of cleaning out Percy, that's the name of our RAV4, who's filled with cups and an assortment of books, clothes, and toys from throughout the week. As I cleared out my messy car, I was startled by a voice that turned out to be familiar.
Hi, how are you?
I'm sorry, I scared you.
Oh, no, how are you?
Sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
I think I remember you from last night. I think I saw you.
Oh, we were there with our girls. Were you were with that lady, I think.
Yes.
It was the same stranger I'd seen in the park the week before and visiting my upstairs neighbor just the other day.
You know, cleaning out the car.
Awesome. Do you need any help here?
No, I got it.
I mean, I could have used the help, but I mean, where would he start? And besides, he's a stranger, so of course, I decline. And by now, Delilah wakes up and finds her shoes so that she can come out and play in the sandbox until I'm done.
Dee Dee, are you okay in the sandbox? Okay, stay on this side, okay?
Mommy went in the house. I'm gonna go play in the car. I think I'll go for a drive.
In the 30 seconds it takes me to drop off a load inside the house from the car, Delilah makes her way inside the car and locks me out.
No.
She honks the horn until I can find my way back in the car to talk to her about why she can't drive, and of course we get the attention of the kind stranger again.
Car, okay? The keys are in the ignition and it's kind of dangerous.
No, Mommy, you need to bother me.
Hey, Mom, are you okay? Everything is okay?
Yeah, she's just mad at me because I won't let her drive.
Don't worry, you'll get your day one day.
Bye.
I rock sweatpants and brown bare feet. No makeup, but I feel sexy. Like my skin out and my hair nappy. Hope you got it.
As I'm loading the kids into the car, which feels a little bit like herding cats, I notice that Flip, that kind stranger, is across the street getting into his car. And he calls my name and tells me that he wants to give me
something.
Okay.
Because he's about to travel back to his home country and someone had done something kind for him and he feels like he should pay it forward to me.
Oh my gosh, that's super kind of you, but I really can't. But
I decline, but he insists that I need to take it. I didn't know exactly what he placed in my hand. I thought maybe it was a bill of some sort, but I wanted to give him something in return. So I rushed inside my house to retrieve a copy of my book, The Journey of Life, 100 Lessons from Around the World, the one that I wrote during that phase of life when I too was a world traveler.
Hey, I'm so sorry. I know you don't want to take anything with you, but I used to travel the world once, and I wrote this book with people from all over the world, and I want to give this to you as another world traveler.
Wow.
Yeah, can I give it to you? Yeah. If you don't want it, you can pay it forward and give
it
to someone
else. Thank you very much. No, I will take it, and I will read it too.
I got into my car where my kids were waiting like little puppies with their noses pressed against the window. That's the day a perfect stranger who called himself Flip put $1,000 in my hand and told me he wanted nothing in return.
What happened? Why are you crying? Are you crying for happiness or sadness? Which one, Mommy? Which
After
one?
After I got myself together, I took the girls out for a waffle at Rooted Cafe, and we bought a hug on the way from Espy's big buddy at school.
Awesome. Do you want to give her a hug?
Hi.
I recognized the familiar struggle from the mom in line in front of us.
Payment was declined. Do you have another card?
Oh, yeah. Never mind. I just come back. Sorry.
We covered the cost of her waffle, and in turn, she offered us a piece of advice that would save our life less than a month later.
Hey!
Yes?
Don't forget to buckle up. I had an accident once, and the seatbelt saved my life.
As for the rest of the money, I bought cashews for Delilah, and Espy took her big buddy from school out for pho at her favorite restaurant.
I used $300 to cover the cost of Espy's dental bill.
$300 for Espy's dentist.
I used $500 for my overdue tuition. And I put the last $77 away to give to my sister during our annual trip to Minneapolis, who helps care for my children so that I can live a version of my dream. The rain came before we got a chance to make it to the park that Sunday afternoon, but we did confirm that we're never alone, that karma is alive and well, and that life is not about waiting for the storm to pass. It's always about learning to dance in the rain.
Cause I flow so sweet. Ooh, baby, baby, come see about me. It's been a long time coming, but eventually I'ma love each and every piece. See them all together as a whole being. Here I am now, look at me. I wonder if you can see what I see. Flaws written all over me. My imperfections like beauty marks. It's been a while, been a while. Been a while since I've left lately. Realize ain't no time for giving up, it's a gift I still breathe. Any day now, let you watch me untie my seams. Pull the thread out, watch me break down, baby, break down.